Saint Joseph stood by Mary, refusing to follow the crowd who judges and condemns with stones in hand. My dear brothers and sisters, as we continue to prepare to receive Christ in this season of Advent, we constantly hear about the yes of Mary and Holy Spirit forming Christ in her womb from that very moment. I would like to reflect with you on how Christ was formed in Joseph much before he was born in the manger in Bethlehem. Joseph, a righteous follower of the law, had every reason to follow the indict of Deuteronomy chapter 22, which held that a betrothed girl, if found not to be a virgin, she must be stoned to death. St. Paul in Romans 4:20 says, Abraham was justified by his faith. Joseph is called righteous to this day, not because of his adherence to law and getting Mary stoned to death, but for the faith he showed in listening to the Holy Spirit. He let Christ be born in him by allowing the Holy Spirit to work. When he took Mary as his wife, when the cold law held for murder, the Spirit prompted him to make a radical choice. If Mary's yes caused the conception of Christ in her womb, Joseph's radical choice definitely causes the conception of Christ in his heart. Joseph's yes to the Spirit is as important as Mary's yes for the birth of Christ on earth. If Joseph had listened to his Spirit instead of the Holy Spirit, Mary and the inventory Jesus would have been stoned to death. His sense of sight and rationality told him to condemn Mary. Adam, the husband of Eve, was deceived by what he saw and heard. The husband of the new Eve, Joseph, did not judge nor condemn by what he saw. He let the Holy Spirit work by hesitating to condemn Mary on the basis of what is seen and heard. He let the Holy Spirit work by his willingness to listen to the Lord and reject what he saw with his eyes. He let the Holy Spirit work by accepting Mary, who had conceived by the Holy Spirit. This docility to the Spirit caused Christ to be born in the heart of his foster father much before he was born in Bethlehem. My dear brothers and sisters, in these turbulent times, a lot of allegations, whether true or false, are raised against the Mother Church. Pope, cardinals, bishops, priests, religious, allegations against all. The Mother of God and the Mother of the Church was saved from death by the patience and docility to the Spirit of her husband 2,000 years back. Today we are in the very same position as that of Joseph. Allegations gallowed against Mother Church. No Gabriel will come to us and tell us the truth of things. But we need to wait for the Lord to act. Psalmist sings in Psalm 46, Be still and know that I am God. Ecclesiastes 3:17 reads, For he has appointed a time for every matter and for every work. This patient waiting is the message of Joseph. If the patience of Joseph saved the Mother of God from being stoned, despite the allegations, our patience will go a long way in saving our Mother Church when allegations are raised against her. Saint Joseph stood by Mary, refusing to follow the crowd who judges and condemns with stones in hand. As we await the birth of the Lord, like Saint Joseph, let us strive to be docile to the Holy Spirit and stand by the Church.